On the phone with us, one of the greatest fighters in the history of boxing, Fernando of Feroz Vargas. Fernando, how are you feeling today?
Good, brother. What's going on?
So much is going on in the boxing world. First of all, have you been watching Floyd Mayweather train, your Olympic teammate? He's looking ready to fight tonight.
He's always in shape, man. One thing about Floyd is that he always takes care of himself, so he doesn't put anything in his body that's going to harm it or, you know, make it deteriorate in any way, shape, or form. So, you know, you really got to take off your hat to Floyd for that, because he lives a very healthy life, you know what I mean? And so, you know, that's something that's kept him on top. That's why one of the biggest reasons that he's, you know, besides his amazing talent, you know what I mean? That goes, to, you know, without saying, but, you know, for him keeping his body intact and always being in shape and, you know, never fluctuating in weight, never drinking, never smoking. So you really got to take off your hat to him for that.
No, absolutely. Now, what was it like being Olympic teammates? How cool was that? You guys friends?
Yeah, I mean, we're always cordial to one another. We never really talked that much, you know what I mean? Because, you know, he was a lighter weight, and he had his little crew that he would hang on. I think he would hang on with David Reed and
Nate Jones, probably?
Nate Jones. And so, you know, I'll hang out with David Diaz. That was only because he was the only Mexican on the team. Me and him. And Albert Hurtado didn't talk Spanish, so he said he didn't consider himself Mexican because he didn't talk Spanish. I said, okay, so let me just talk to him.
That's funny. But Fernando, I got to ask you this. Mike Tyson, obviously, he lived in Vegas, you live in Vegas. I know that I've seen pictures of Mike Tyson in your locker room, Mike Tyson there with you in the ring. Tell me about what was that all about?
That, to me, was one of the most humbling moments in my life when they say Mike Tyson wants to walk out with you before I even knew him. And I was like, are you freaking shitting me? You know what I mean? Are you serious? And so it was a humbling moment for me when you're a superstar, you know, living legend, just, you know, wants to walk out with you. What do you say? I mean, it's like, you know, Shelly Finkel told me that, you know, Mike wanted to walk me out. I said, it's not even a question. You don't even have to ask me. To me, it's an honor to have such a great champion and a living legend like him to walk me out, such a badass, the baddest man on the planet. You know what I mean? So, to walk me out, absolutely. Absolutely.
You know, by the way, he has a son named Miguel, who's from Guadalajara. Did you know that?
No, man.
Yeah?
I'm sure. How many kids does he have?
I don't know, but he has a son who's Mexican.
Yeah, well, you know, he was a Rolling Stone.
So what was it like being friends with Mike Tyson? Because you were a big star. Everybody loved you.
Well, you know, you gotta understand that you're still to me and to anybody my age, that's still Mike Tyson. It's like when he's before me, and you know, I saw him knock out so many people and just be a savage in the ring and an animal, a killer. And to me, I'm like, when they told me Mike Tyson wants to work here, I said, Mike Tyson knows who I am? Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's like one of those moments in your life where you're like, what? Mike Tyson knows who I am? He knows who I am? He goes, yeah, he knows who you are. I'm like, what in the world? So that to me was a moment where you feel like, you know, you made it. It's like one of those I made it moments.
And how is there, now obviously you become friends with him over the years. What do you guys talk about when you hang out, or what do you tell him?
We talk about, you know, just, we don't really talk too much. I mean, but when we do talk, when I see him, you know, we're just, hey, Mike, how you doing? How have you been? What are you up to? Stuff like that, you know what I mean? But, you know, it's not like, you know, we're amazing friends. You know, we're just like, I know him. He's a good dude. Well, whenever we see each other, we're cordial. We hug each other. I saw him at the fights with you, and you told him that I wanted to take a picture, and he came right away. He said right away, he got up right away. So that to me is still humbling to this day, because, you know,
Yeah, I remember. I forgot about that. Yeah, he was really cool. He was happy to see your kids too.
Yeah, man. So,
speaking of which, Fernando, so you have three sons. I think they'll all be champ. You have a daughter too, but three of your sons are going to be world champion.
She's gonna whoop everybody's ass. She's better than they are.
Did she start boxing yet?
Not yet, but I'm gonna make her fight.
Okay.
And only because if I'm not there or brothers are not there to protect her, and some jackass might put her hands on her, some coward might try to put her hands on her, then she's gonna throw some punches and be like, "Fool, don't you know who my daddy is, you punk? You don't ever put your hands on me." And she's gonna whoop him.
No.
So my boys, you know, they're doing great. You know, Junior, won a tournament pro this year. We're still in the gym, you know, but my gym is closed. It's a private gym, so, you know, it's not like I'm open to the public. So it's just me and my boys, and that's it. So, you know, that's COVID-19. We got to work.
I saw you were losing a lot of weight, and the first thing you told me today on the phone is, like, I have a big dramatic announcement, and I believed you. That you're coming back. You could fight 160, 168, 175.
Pato, I never fight again. I only fight with my wife, and I won't let her win all those fights because this relationship has lasted this year 26 years.
Amazing.
This woman has put up with me. So you guys go, those say, "Oh my God, you guys, you're so awesome, Fernando." You know, that's my white talk. "Hey, oh my God, Fernando, you're so awesome, you know. You must be such an amazing, you know, husband." I'm not, but I got an amazing wife.
No.
So, yeah. 26 years.
Amazing. Congratulations. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.